Hi, and welcome to this week's episode of The Shtick. We're still under lockdown. I'm in the living room, the usual thing. But to make things really interesting, I've invited David Southwick, MP, to speak to me for one or two segments. And I'd like to say hello, David.
G'day, Henry, and good to talk to you again on The Shtick.
Yeah, I know. You've been on quite a few times. And this time I'd like to introduce you as the deputy leader of the Liberal opposition in the state parliament.
Yeah, thank you. I've had a bit of a change to my titles. I've got a few different titles now, including the deputy leader of the Liberal Party. So very excited with that. Lots of work to do. We're focused at the moment on an alternative government, not an opposition. So we want to lay out a bit more hope, a bit more optimism, which I know the Shtick's all about that. And that's going to be our focus between now and November 2022, when we're going to have another election. A bit of time and ahead, but, you know, I think we've got some work to do, and we want to ensure that the public understand what alternatives they're under are under us and Matthew Guy.
Yeah, I was going to mention Matthew Guy because he is a good guy. I liked him before. Michael O'Brien was good, but he lacked the charisma and the kind of spunk. You know, Matthew is a spunky guy.
Well, he's got lots of passion, that's for sure. And I know we spoke about the ever-ready before in terms of just full of life, and he is the ever-ready bunny, if you like. I don't know whether it's the but he's full of excitement and passion and enthusiasm. He loves our state, so do I. And we just think that there's got to be a better way than lockdowns. I mean, we're now at the most lockdown city in the world, Victoria,
which
is not a good title for anyone to have. It's really, really heartbreaking, I've got to say, as a passionate Victorian. I love this state. And it's not a title that we want. We were the most livable city. Now we're the most lockdown city. And we've got to change it. We've got to give people a pathway. We've got to give them hope. We've got to open up. We've got to get on with our lives. We've got to put some fun back. We've got to put some hope back. We've got to get our kids back to school. And we've got to get small businesses back. And ultimately, we've just got to get on with our lives in a COVID-safe way, but we've got to get on with our lives.
So you've got some new portfolios, and one of them is related to small business and the economy.
Yeah. Yeah, so I've got jobs and employment. They're all business-related, so jobs and employment, small business, the events industry, which obviously I have an events background, so it's good to be able to have an events industry portfolio, precincts, CBD recovery and business recovery more generally. A lot of what I'm be focused on is recovering and rebuilding the state. So a lot for me does start with small business, because I think small business provide that kind of hope and opportunity. People don't really understand what small business is when you talk about it, but, you know, it could be a radio show, it could be a cafe, a restaurant, a bar, a hairdresser, all the way through to retail. There are so many small businesses each and every day. They employ more people than any other sector at all. They're made up of families, mums, dads, workers. They're made up of ordinary Victorians that just want to have a go, and they've been absolutely let down over the last 200 and something days, and they just want to get on with it. Many of them have gone to the wall, and we've got to make sure that we support those that are left.
Something I did want to discuss with you before we get back to the other issues related to the COVID affair is that you've been able to put a ban on the Nazi flag. I think that's a really big issue that you've been following and trying to create a momentum in trying to ban the flag, and you finally achieved it.
Well, the legislation is not before Parliament now, but the government is now committed to actually bring the legislation before Parliament. It's something that I've been talking about for a long time now. Just on about 15 months ago, I got the Liberal Nationals to sign up to a policy to ban Nazi symbols, including the Nazi swastika or the Nazi swastika. And we've been pushing really hard. We've got bipartisan support with that. We'll be the first state in Australia to actually ban the Nazi swastika. I think it's very, very important in terms of uniting people, particularly against those that seek to hate, those that seek to target individuals because of their race, ethnic background. We don't need it. We need to unite people at the moment. And I think that is a very important, it's not just a symbolic thing, but it's a very important thing for us to do in Victoria that celebrates diversity and multiculturalism. And I'm really, really proud to be able to have done that.
Wonderful. What I wanted to just jump straight to is something related to the swastika, and that's the implication that the people who have been demonstrating throughout this whole pandemic have been labelled as neo-Nazis. Now, do you think that's true?
Oh, look, I don't know. In terms of who's protesting, there's a whole range of people protesting. I'm not going to target or label people. I've said all along that now is not the time to protest. I've been very consistent with that, and largely because we are in the middle of a pandemic, and I know people are upset, I know people are angry, and I know that people feel really let down by their government. But, you know, having thousands of people in the streets protesting, I don't think helps us one bit. I think violence never, ever is acceptable. I think there is a line between freedom of speech and violence, and when you cross that, there needs to be consequences. And I know people have been talking about, you know, whether police have been heavy-handed and everything else. I was a former shadow police minister. I know how hard it is in terms of the frontline police. I speak to hundreds of them. I know certainly that many of those police that I speak to, the last thing they want to be doing is outside the front of a protest. I've just actually spoken to a number of them today that have, you know, over the week been involved in the protest with the CFMEU and others that have taken to the streets. They absolutely hate it. They really do. That's not what they signed up for. And, you know, I think we need calm. We need leadership. Certainly people aren't happy. Certainly, you know, there is an argument to be had in terms of the construction industry and the gripes that the construction industry have with mandatory vaccinations. I accept that, but you don't turn to violence. And I think when you see, and I'm not suggesting that everybody at the protest has been violent, but when you see people being kicked, spat on, hit, dogs being kicked, all that stuff, that's just unacceptable in my books.
I'd like to bring you back in the next segment to talk about mandatory vaccination and other issues in relation to alternatives to the treatment that is what we think is the way out of all this, and that's the vaccine, because I'd like to just get some opinions on that.
Sure. Happy to talk about anything, Henry. You know that.
I know. Well, we'll see you in the next segment with David Southwick, MP.